Hello friends, welcome to Android Gateway YouTube channel. In this tutorial, you will learn how to pass GoTranscript MCQs test and audio test as well. So first of all, you must read GoTranscription guideline rule. This transcription guideline rule is very important. You must read all these guidelines all the way to the end, 1 to 2 times. This will help you during the MCQs test as well as audio test. Because audio test is very important, you must apply all these guidelines into the audio test before submitting it. Without applying guideline, you never pass GoTranscript audio test. So after reading all this transcription guideline, let's start the test. So first test is MCQs test. And to apply for transcribable position, you must complete quiz 100% correct using our guideline. Each question can have one or more correct answer. So first question is, if there is an etc. in the audio, what should you do? There is 3 different option. If you check in transcription guideline using Control plus F command, and here is, do not remove word etc. unless the client asks otherwise in the comment section. So according to the transcription guideline, and option B is the correct option, transcribe etc. as a part of the audio. So first question answer is B. Second question is, the correct form of timestamping is? There is 4 different option. If we check in transcription guideline, and so here is timestamping. Time format must be in this form and always in bold. So this is the correct format of timestamping. So according to the transcription guideline, option C is the correct option of question 2. Third question is, what is the rule about these small bracket in Go transcription guideline? So here is 2 different option. If we check in transcription guideline, and here is, never use this small bracket instead of large brackets. So according to the transcription guideline, third question answer is first one, small bracket should never be used for the timestamping. For instance, this is a correct form of timestamping and this is not. So that's why third question answer is first one. Fourth question is, if there is the word that have cannot hear due to the heavy background noise, what do you have to do? There is 3 different option, and correct option is option B. Option B is the correct option of fourth question. If there is a heavy background noise, so mark it as unaudible with the correct time according to the audio. If you have any doubt related to this question, you simply check transcription guideline to understand why this answer is correct answer of fourth question. Fifth question is, if you are working on the part of 5 to 15 minutes, timestamping every 30 seconds should start at. So here is 5 different option, and if you are working on a part of 5 to 15 minutes, so option B is the correct option of fifth question. If you have any doubt, you simply read timestamping section of Go transcription guideline and you understand why this question answer is this option B option is correct option of fifth question. Sixth question is, if the quality of audio and video file is not good, what do you have to do? There is 3 different option, and if the audio is unavailable, let the support know about. In this case, code transcription will contact the client and provide him with the refund. And option B is also correct. If many parties simply unreachable due to the essence or topic, leave the file for other people who may provide quality work. So, sixth question answer is A and B. If you have any doubt, you simply check transcription guideline to understand why this answer is question. So, seventh part is sometimes the quality of audio and video file are variable. So, please let us know about that. We will contact the client and provide a refund for that file. That's why sixth question answer is A and B. Seventh question is, what are the basic rules to apply while transcribing an audio file CleanWAR PTM? So, if you read CleanWAR PTM section in Code Transcription Guideline, you easily understand the answer of this question. So, seventh question answer is, the beginning of sentence should always be capitalized, and option C is also correct. Longer speech should be separated into smaller paragraph, and so on. So, seventh question answer is A and C. Eighth question is, if there is a combination of single digit numerals and all other numerals in the same sentence, for example, I have 150 pencil, how will you transcribe it? So, here is four different options, and correct option is option D. If you have any doubt, simply read transcription guideline in numeral section and you understand why this option is correct option. Ninth question is, if a speaker spelled a word, how will it look in the transcription? So here is four different option, and correct option is option one, means option A is the correct option of the ninth question. If you have any doubt, you simply read guidelines related to spell the word in code transcription guideline. And 10th and last question is, which sentence is correctly capitalized and punctuated? So here is five different options, and correct option is option A. 10th question answer is first one, A. So after R, you need to simply click on confirm. After clicking on confirm, you move to the next page of code transcript audio test. So before starting audio test, make sure you must read code transcription guideline rules. These guideline rules are very important. You must read all these guidelines before starting the audio test. Without applying these guidelines, you never pass code transcript audio test. So make sure you read this transcription guideline and understand, and also apply code transcription guideline rule into the audio test before submitting it. If you need help how we apply code transcription guideline into the audio test, so you check the old test on Go Transcription website, in which you understand how we apply Go Transcription guideline into the audio file. So after checking Go Transcription guideline and old test, let's start audio test. I already transcribed this file into text form, and you need to simply apply all Go Transcription guideline before submitting the audio test. So let's start the audio test.
This audio is used for the transcriber test at Go Transcript.
You know, you can ice just about any noun you want and turn it into a verb. I was thinking about that when I found a piece of bread that was starting to get stale. Could I croutonize it? Possibly, but the point is, the fact that I thought of turning crouton into a verb probably says more about me than about the boy, but perhaps I've been working at Go Transcript just a little too long, is what I'm saying. Anyway, the best way to make croutons out of stale bread is, first of all, make sure the bread isn't completely stale. It shouldn't have icky black mold on it, unless you're running low on penicillin, in which case, toss it into your medicine chest and wait. No, your future potential crouton bread should be just a couple of days past its due date. It should just be starting to feel a little rocky, like Mrs. Stallone.
This audio is used for the transcriber test at Go Transcript.
Before croutonizing it, melt a little butter and pour it over your bread. Let it sink into every crevasse till the bread is entrancingly yellow and yummy. Let it sit for a few minutes to cool down. Now sprinkle your favorite seasoning on it, like garlic, onion, pumpkin spice, herbs de Provence, Go Transcript Masala blend, or whatever. Now take a really sharp knife, like the kind Lorena Bobbitt used on her husband's baguette. Cut up your bread into small cubes. Put them on a smooth Teflon baking sheet and stick them in the oven for a while. You don't actually have to turn the oven on. In fact, it's better not to. The main thing is that you leave them in a warm place for a while. Take them out later and voila, you've croutonized your focaccia. Aren't you proud? Of course, you can do this with pretty much any kind of bread. Some don't need as much seasoning as others. In fact, a good pumpernickel or ciabatta is just as good. The only kind that don't seem to work with this process is King's Hawaiian, mainly because it never stays around our Go Transcript break room long enough to start getting stale. One caution, however. If your bread is made from potatoes, rice, or some other farinaceous vegetable, it may be easier to convert it into a very pleasant fermented bread, aka beer. In fact, it's been my experience that if you're working with hops, you should hop to it.
This audio is used for the transcriber test at Go Transcript.
So friend, this is the audio test for today. I hope this video is helpful for you. And before submitting this audio test, make sure you apply all Go Transcription guideline rules into it. So friend, thank you very much. See you soon.